Hey everyone, it's Kat and welcome back to my channel. So I have a series but not really thing for you guys, and I'm going to be drawing some of the main characters from The Kill Order by James Dasnher. So today I am calling Alec for you guys. Before I begin, I want to apologize for the camera. I auto-focused it and it didn't focus where I wanted it to, right there. And I think it started focusing more on his arms and his face. So I want to apologize for that. It might be slightly out of focus. One of these days I'm going to get the camera right. But I'm also trying out different camera angles. I might change it up in the next video. That'll probably happen. So please just bear with me on that. But anyway, on to the character description. So I imagined Alec kind of buff, but not super anime abs with chicken cutlets duct taped to himself, more of just kind of stocky and brawny, I suppose, and it made a lot of references that he was the quote-unquote the old bear, so I guess I didn't imagine him, like, old as in on his little motorized wheelchair, hearing aids, and, like, really big bifocals or anything. I imagined him kind of old as in wise and just kind of midlife, kind of based his character off of Tommy Chandler, which is from The Last Ship. Watch a lot of those shows. Anyway, so that's kind of who I kind of based him off of, yeah. So, yep, into the actual coloring itself. So I am using a lot of Prismacolor pencils. I didn't have that many color selections in my Prismacolor markers. I love them so much. I'm the type of girl that would walk into a Copa convention, have a normal shirt on, and rip off her shirt, and underneath be a shirt that said, "I love Prismacolors." I would do that. But anyway, so, yep. I also messed up a big time, I guess, on his pants. I looked at, like, the pants reference. I was like, oh yeah, I've done pants before. I just kind of went and grabbed colors, and they were the wrong colors. They were too purple. They were more purple than blue, and they looked like peacock pants, and I was like, oh yeah, I can fix it. I can fix it by adding some black and making the pants darker, but it didn't react well, and everything I did just made it look so muddy and gross, so I reached for my last resort and grabbed a Prismacolor marker. And of course, markers don't work very well on wax, they work the opposite way around. You layer down some marker and then you put some colored pencils over it. And yeah, so basically it was like I was writing on a whiteboard. I could actually smudge the ink with my finger. It wasn't holding on to the paper. So I kind of used it to my advantage just to try to blend some of the things together. And off camera, I took a knife to the pants and scraped off some of the waxy surface. And I guess it didn't look too bad, but not as good as I wanted it to look. Didn't look, I guess, as detailed as the other things. I kind of wanted it to look really rough, and because they're on the apocalypse after all. So right here I'm adding kind of dark shades to his skin because solar flares devastated the earth. So it makes sense that he would be really, really like sunburnt. It doesn't look as sunburnt as I kind of wanted to. I might go back and add some red tinges just to make it look darker and sell it more. So yeah, I basically just use a lot of Prismacolor everything. I try to add some finer details, but I couldn't really find that much. Things like to add like highlights and junk. So yeah. I also forgot to mention this. He was in the Air Force, so that's why he's kind of buff and wears dog tags. So yeah, I drew a lot of inspiration from The Walking Dead because it takes place in the far future, but I didn't want it to look like Star Wars clothes weird, so I always imagined them with normal clothes, but whatever. So yeah, I think that's all I have to say for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I had a fun time drawing this. I'm actually pretty happy with how it turned out. I don't draw guys that often, especially older ones. So yeah, I'm pretty content with this. I hope you guys like it, and I will let you know some update stuff about scheduling and when next videos will be posted. So without further ado, I hope you guys have a wonderful and blessed day, and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye!